गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द डिफरेंट प्लांट लेआउट्स। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव कवर्ड व्हाट इज प्लांट लेआउट, व्हाट थिंग्स आर नीडेड इन अ गुड प्लांट लेआउट, right? And what is the principles of plant layout? But in today's class, we will discuss two different types of plant layouts. What are they? One is your process layout and another one is your product layout. See, I think my screen is visible to you all. Okay, very good. See, in the previous class we have discussed that few principles of your plant layout. Those are integration, minimum moments and material handling, smooth and continuous flow, cubic space utilization, safe and improved environment, and flexibility. Basing on these six principles, we will divide our plant layout into three different types of layout. Those are your process layout, product layout, and combination layout. Actually, there are many types of layout, but these three are important as per your subject point of view, because depending upon these three, means these three will give you a basic idea regarding the plant layout. See, you will start from process layout. This is also known as a functional layout, as we are keeping the similar machines together, or the machine performing a type of process or similar type of process, we are keeping the machines together. Like, see, this is an example. Initially, I am showing an example. Here, two jobs are prepared for kitchen cabinet, job X and job Y. In process layout, you have to divide the whole thing into processes, different processes, and you have to divide the machineries as per the process. See, this is the first section, you can say. This is where you will receive the raw material and store the raw material over there. It is quite like your inventory. Then your foundry, then this is the thing where you will do rock machining. Here, shear and punching section is here. Finishing machining is here. Fabrication, then here deburring, assembly, painting, packing and shipping. This is a different section, and your arrow mark shows the product or material flow. Material means your semi-finished material also. Raw material and semi-finished material. See what happens in this job X. Once get unloaded into your storage, then it goes to foundry, then it goes for rough machining, then shear and punch, then it goes to deburring, then fabrication, assembly, and packing and slipping system. Right, but whereas your job Y, once it get unloaded in your raw material section, it directly goes to shear and punch section, then finish machining section, deburring section, assembly, then painting, then it goes to packing and shipping. Similarly, if you are adding another job, suppose that is your job Z, what you will do? You will find the production flow line. Then you will go as per the production flow, as per the section. We will go to different sections as per the production flow. Okay, I think all of you have understood the example. Okay, I think all of you are no one is facing any issue. It is also known as functional layout. It is characterized by keeping similar machines or similar operations at one location or place. In other word, means in simple word, you can define all lathes will be at one place, all milling machines will be at one place, at another, and so on. Similarly, if you have different types of machines, like your drilling machines will be at one place, grinding machines will be at one place, your casting machines will be molding machines. It depends completely upon the machines. Depending upon the machine, you will set up different sections. Machines have been arranged according to their functions. This type of layout is generally employed for the industry engaged in job order production and non-repetitive kind of maintenance or manufacturing activities. What will happen in process layout? Any type of product that is coming to your industry, you can perform if you have that type of machine. In process layout, you can do a variety of job. See, right now I will discuss about product layout. Then we will go for then we'll compare, and then we'll go for advantages and disadvantages of process layout and product layout. We will study those two layout in comparison. See, this is the second type of layout, that is a product layout. This is also called as a line type of layout. Why it is called as a line type of layout? It completely follow the production line. How? See the diagram. Suppose your product, suppose that product X takes the following process. It will go to lathe, then your drilling machine, then milling machine, then again drilling machine, then grinding machine. See, depending upon the processes, you will set up your layout. Suppose your job requires these five processes, what you will do, depending upon the job, you will set up your section, which will consist of five machines, these five machines. Once your raw material will enter this, in this section, once after the lathe machine working, then it will go to drill, then it will go to milling, then it will go to drilling again, then to grinder, and you will get your final output in the same section. In the same section you have all the machines. That means you are following the product production line. What process the product is following, you are following that process. And as per the process, you have sorted your machine. That is why it is called as a line type of layout. If a different product comes to your industry, what will happen? You need to prepare a separate layout for that product. You need to prepare a separate layout for that product. Suppose another product came, which has a process like your lathe. After that, it will go to milling. After that, it will go to drilling. After that, again, it goes to milling. Then you are grinding. In this case, in that case, what you need to do, you need to set up another layout depending upon the another product. See here, you can see it is also known as a line or type of layout. Line or type layout, it implies that the various operations on the raw material are performed in sequence and the machines are placed along the production flow line. This type of layout is preferred for continuous production involving continuous flow of the process material towards the finished product stage, because generally we follow this process where we need mass production and your product is not going to change very often. It is generally used in the industries like cement, steel production, sugar industries, fertilizer industry and other metal extraction plants, where your production flow line is not going to change. Means once you have installed, once you have made a layout, it will go on what? It will go on producing the product throughout the year, or it will go on producing a product even 10 years, after 20 years, after 30 years, it will going on producing the same product. In that case, you can go for a product layout. Is there any doubt regarding these two type of layout? Are you facing any issues regarding those two type of layout? Vishnu? Sorry, Vishnu, you are not audible. Still, you are not audible, Vishnu. Vishnu, you can raise the question in the chat box also. Okay, I got your question, Vishnu. Sir, in product layout, why there are two lathes and two milling machine? Okay. See, this is an example where it is showing two lathes and two milling machine. Suppose your lathe machine, why it has been done? I'm telling you, in this lathe machine, you are getting a product within 10 minutes, and again in the lathe machine you are getting the semi-finished product in 10 minutes. But what is happening in drilling machine? Your drilling machine, you are performing the function in 5 minutes, right? After 5 minutes, your drilling machine is getting idle. What is happening in that case? You need two lathe machines in order to perform, so that in order to prepare a semi-finished product, so that your drill machine will not remain idle. That is why it is going like this. Again, this is an example, and that is completely dependent on the product and the number of the product you are going to prepare in a day or in a depending upon the order quantity. This no, did I answer your question? Okay, next go to the second part, which will do with comparison. See, after understanding the two types of layout, that is your process layout and product layout, what are the advantages of process layout? It gives you a wide flexibility. How? And a lot of variety of job you can produce. Wide flexibility exists as regard allotment of work to equipments and worker. Better utilization of available equipments, because a lot of job you can take, so that a lot of job order you can take, a lot of order from different industries you can take, a lot of order from different for different parts you can take, so that what is happening, your all machines can be utilized to the maximum extent. Comparatively less number of machines are needed, thus involving reduced capital investment. Suppose here, see what is happening in this case, sear and punching. In the same section or same machine is used by two jobs, but in case of product layout, same machine is used by a single job. That is the advantages of a process layout. Here, single machine can be used by different types of jobs. Better product quality because of the supervisors and the worker and attained to one type of machines of operations. As your worker or supervisor attending a single type of machine, so they are getting they get expert of that machine with time. So we can assure better product quality in this type of layout. Variety of job coming as different job order make the work more interesting for the workers. So, that means you are not going to prepare a similar kind of product every day. Worker in the section are not affected by the nature of operation carried out in another section. There is a section like your lathe section, there is a section like your milling section. So in two different section, whatever you are doing in milling, worker in the lathe, they are not at all concerned about that thing. There is an example. A lathe operator is not affected by the rays of the welding, as two sections are quite separate sections. See, right now we will discuss the advantages of product layout. See, less space requirement for the same volume of production. Suppose for job X, you have set up a process layout, and for job X, you have set up a product layout. It takes, in this case, the product layout takes a less space as you are depending upon the production flow line. Automatic material handling movements, as all the things happens in the same section, so there is a less movement of material. It saves times and cost. Less process inventory, as all the machines will be utilized, you set up all the machines as per the production line or a production line flow. What happens, you design the production flow so that there will be no idle machine throughout the process, so you will find less inventory process inventory, which is called product case completed in lesser time, as there is no space for material handling, no space, no no chance of your what as material handling, and see in this case sometimes what happens, as we all are humans, if we are doing a product and from once we are taking a product from one section to section 3, 2 to 3, what happens sometimes, we take a break like thing which affects the production flow time. But in case of your product layout, there is no chance of those kind of things, because the same in the same section, or you can say that in the same room you find all the things. Better coordination and simple production planning and control, smooth and continuous workflow, less skilled worker may serve the purpose, because as per the product you need to prepare your workforce. Then disadvantages. See, the disadvantages of process layout, we will see these are not the disadvantages actually, because depending upon the requirement of the industry chooses the process layout or product layout. So these are the disadvantages as compared to your these disadvantages of process layout is as compared to your product layout. These are the disadvantages, but actually these are not the disadvantages, because some may be disadvantages for industry X, but that is disadvantages for industry Y, because they are following the one is following the product layout, another one is following the process layout. What is the disadvantages of process layout as compared to your product layout? For the same amount of production, process layouts need more space, because you are setting up different sections for different machines. Automatic material handling is extremely difficult, because you need to go to another, if you want to go to another machine, you need to go to different section. More material in process remains in queue for further operations, as I said earlier. More in process inventory. Completion of same product takes more time. Production control becomes difficult, as you are getting a lot of in process inventory. In that case, your production controls becomes difficult. Raw material has to travel a larger distance for being processed to finished good. This increases the material handling and associated cost with the material handling, so that what happens, your total cost also increases. It needs more inspection and efficient coordination. These are the disadvantages of your process layout as compared to your product layout. See, again we'll discuss the disadvantages of product layout as compared to your process layout. Again I'll say that these are not the disadvantages of product layout. These are the disadvantageous things when compared to your process layout. Since the specified product determines the layout, a change in the product involves the major change in layout. A simple change in the product that leads to major change in your layout. If you are not changing the layout, it becomes very difficult for you to produce the same product. Thus, layout flexibility is considerably reduced. Here, you find a very less flexibility in your layout. The pace and rate of working depends upon the output rate of the slowest machine. Thus, it results in excessive idle time for other machines. Suppose in this case, what happens? Your one machine gets damaged, or one machine breakdowns. What happens? Your total production flow. What happens? Your total production line gets stopped. But if you are using process layout. If your one machine is not working, other machines are there in the section to perform the work of that machine, so that your production never stops. Machines are scattered along the line. More machines of each type is to be needed, or it is purchased for keeping few as standby, because if a machine of a production line fails, it will lead to complete shutdown of the production of that product. Though it involves less supervision as compared to process layout, sometimes it becomes difficult when an inspector has to look after many machines in many production lines. So when inspection is carried out, he has to go product by product. So it often become difficult, because when he has to go product by product, he will go to lathe machine. He need to carry the tool required for the lathe. Then he need to go for drilling machine, and the tools are again different. Then milling machine, again tools are different. So it becomes difficult for the inspection. Difficult for the inspection. Whereas in the same section, all the lathes are there. When an inspector goes for inspection, he carries the tool of only lathe machines, and he do all type of inspection of the lathe. So it becomes easier. It is difficult to produce beyond the capacity of the production line. What is the capacity of the production line? It becomes difficult to produce beyond that. So these two are your basic type of layout, that is your product layout and process layout, and the advantages and disadvantages of your product and process layout we studied and made a comparison among those two type of layout. In the next class, we will study your combination layout. Combination layout is the combination of your product and process layout that gives more flexibility. What happens? You get few advantages. We have taken the few advantages from your process layout and few advantages from a product layout, and combined that and made a separate type of layout, that is your combination layout. Is there any doubt regarding these two type of layout? You can ask in the chat box. Is there any doubt? Think you don't have any doubt, or hopefully you all have understood it. Okay, I'm stopping the recording.